Do you believe in aliens? While some of us might roll our eyes at the mention of UFOs, others want to know more about the possibilities out there. And US filmmaker James Fox, he is among them, and he's looking for evidence of alien encounters and UFO activity to reveal what he says is a worldwide cover-up. He's already collected plenty of accounts, but now James is in Australia to interview some of our homegrown UFO witnesses. Please welcome him to Studio 10. Hello. When did you come to believe that that UFOs and extraterrestrials really exist?
So I have to make the distinction here. I generally steer clear from saying extraterrestrials are related to UFOs.
Okay.
I think that if by the process of elimination, you might determine that once you've canceled everything else out, what's left, and that would lead you to think that we are probably being visited, but I don't draw that conclusion quickly. I'm very cautious with that assertion.
And it's interesting what you were saying
so
earlier.
So what does that mean, though? Sorry, I don't understand that.
That means that there's a small percentage of UFO encounters that I would say defy a terrestrial explanation. And those are the encounters that I focus on, and one of which occurred here in Australia.
I'm going to ask you about that later.
Yes, sorry.
Yeah.
Exactly. So we're not talking about the tinfoil hat brigade here. You're applying fairly rigorous methods. And then you've interviewed Air Force generals, astronauts, commercial pilots and government officials. And I understand that recently you spoke to John Podesta, who was Hillary Clinton's campaign
chairman. Is that where the emails came from?
Yes.
So what really happened in Benghazi? So what are the most compelling stories that you've heard?
The most compelling stories I heard was that there was true effort for government transparency with the Clinton administration. Even an executive order 12958 was signed, and that they were not happy with the answers they were getting. So
really?
If presidents aren't happy with the answers they're getting, that tells you that there's something, you know, going on in the background, that elected representatives are left out of the loop.
But is it true that Bill Clinton tried to find out the proof but was thwarted?
Very much so, yes. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? And who was stopping it?
He said they weren't happy with the answers they were getting from the military. They were making inquiries, and he even signed an executive order that everything that was 25 years or older should be released, and they were just coming up with sort of not a lot.
So what do you think it actually is? Are there sort of UFO spaceships coming here to visit us, or what do you think?
Okay, so this is after speculation, but informed speculation. There are structured craft of unknown origin whizzing around with impunity in our airspace. Okay. And that any government official, most of them know that, when I say government official, most of the military people know that this is probably the case, but there's so much stuff they don't know that for them to come forward and disclose what they do know would open up a can of worms. So they know that these things are whizzing around with impunity. They know that they fly rings around our fastest jets. They know that it's a global phenomenon, and it's physical, at least.
So why don't they say anything, though? That's the part that I struggle
with. Because they don't have the answers. They don't know
what they are or where they're from.
I've interviewed high-ranking military government officials, and they've said to me, we just don't know where they come from. We don't know what they want. We don't know what their agenda is, and we're never going to disclose that.
So what do they know, though? Do they know that...
They know that they're under intelligent control. They know that it's a global phenomenon. They know that there's physical trace cases, photographic radar confirmation, visual confirmation. They know that it's clearly under intelligent control. They know there's an intelligence behind it, and its technology is light years beyond ours.
And former military people are telling you this on the record?
Absolutely on camera, yes.
Wow. Yeah.
So, James, let's talk about an astronaut's perspective, Buzz Aldrin. I'm assuming he'd know a bit about it. You're about to go and interview him in Monte Carlo.
I
pulled the pin. Why?
Oh, boy, that was a frustrating one. I borrowed money against getting a whole camera crew together, flew to the south of France, and he kept postponing the interview, and I finally said, I think after day five, this is really expensive in Monte Carlo. I mean, it was like, you know, very expensive to be there. And I said,
you were losing
with
the
all
tables.
There he is.
Do you think he saw something when he was on the moon?
No, they saw something inexplicable on the way to the moon, and there was another encounter that he had while piloting a jet airplane, which he told his sister, Faye Ann Potter, who I was friends with, about these incidents that are never explained. Wow. But he pulled the plug on the interview in the morning of where we were supposed to do it in a hotel room, and he said Paul Allen had just invested in SETI, which is Search for Extraterrestrial search for extraterrestrial intelligence, and he was labeled a UFO nut and didn't want to jeopardize trying to get funding to put civilians into space for these rockets. And he just said, I can't do it.
So is this why you look for group encounters? I mean, you're here, you're going to be looking at a Westall, aren't you? Which was an event that happened in 1966 in Victoria where 200 students and teachers saw
something,
a UFO. And you're here, so you're looking for groups, you're looking for numbers, are you?
I feel like on its own, if you just covered this 1966 Westall case, which was 200 witnesses in broad daylight, it's an amazing case, then people would say, yeah, I don't believe that actually happened. But if you start seeing a pattern and you cover cases in South America, cases in Africa, cases in the United States that I'm doing, and you start to build your case, then I think it becomes much more digestible to mainstream, and that's what I'm trying to do with my film.
So why are you so passionate about it? Why is it something that you have invested clearly your life's work in?
Okay, well, I'll answer that with a question to you guys. If Earth was being visited, just suspend judgment. Would you consider that a significant discovery?
Absolutely.
I suppose.
But
would you?
Yes, but have you?
I'm convinced it's happening.
I think it's fascinating, but I mean, statistically, it's statistically almost impossible that there aren't other alien life forms out there. But if all these UFOs and all these visitations are so ubiquitous, why is it still in so much doubt? With all the technology we have, with 7 billion people on the planet, why is it still such a fringe science and there hasn't been that conclusive evidence? You'd think surely if something had happened, we'd all know about
That's the million-dollar question. I mean, there's a preponderance of evidence in terms of eyewitness and radar and photographic and landing case traces, but from around the world, which is incredibly compelling. And how many of your viewers out here actually know that there was a landing in 1966 with over 200 witnesses at 11 o'clock in the morning that lasted 20 minutes long? Yeah. Most people have never heard of such
like
a thing. And when you tell them, they go, that didn't happen. If that happened, of course I'd know about it.
In fact, officials or first responders at Westall, you're wanting them to get in touch. You have an email address that people can get hold of you on?
Pretty pleased with sugar on top. JamesCFox@gmail.com. If there's any civilians or military or fire department or police department that have any information or any involvement with that case, please get in touch with me. I'd love to hear from you.
All right, James Fox, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.